We can never get enough of ethnic wear, be it easy breezy kurtas, gorgeous lehengas or elegant sarees.
And our B-town celebrities are definitely serving us some inspiration with these looks.
So today we're looking at some of the ethnic wear looks our celebrities wore in this episode of
Crush or Crash. First on the list is Tapsee Pannu. Tapsee Pannu is wearing this white set from Diksha Khanna, designer Diksha Khanna. What I love about this look, first, it's very summer.
Yeah.
Coming down to the way it's been styled, it's a basic white kurta, and instead of making it boring, she uplifted the entire look with the classic combination of going with black jewelry. She has layered neck pieces, and one neck piece has this blue undertone. It just gives you a nice pop of color, then the huge earrings and the chunky rings. It's a very smartly styled look, like it's not over, but it's definitely something that will make you want to talk about it or look at it
again.
Yeah, true. I mean, so I personally think it's a very, very nicely styled look.
Okay, so I absolutely love it. It's a very, like a very Banjaran inspired jewelry look. Dhoti pants, which is interesting, and short kurta, which is in fashion these days. So that is really nice. It's airy, breezy, white, and it's that super thin cotton wala fabric, which I love. It has been styled so well with the jewelry, layered neck pieces, those huge earrings, you know. And so I think that's giving a very earthy and a very ethnic vibe to it. Love the makeup, like how she went for like really neutral tones on her face. It's very like nude lips and brown eyes and that low bun with just strands, some strands coming out, which is like framing her face so nicely. So it's a really well put together look, and she's carrying it with like utmost grace. So I think that's lovely. And yeah, we both are definitely crushing it. Okay, so next in the list is Shayoni Gupta. So she's wearing this beautiful green Banarasi sari by Ikaya Banaras. That's the brand. And I have to say, it is a beauty. She paired it with this trappy spaghetti blouse by Ikaya again. So, and it's of this really light pink tone color blouse, and the sari is of course green. And so love the color and love the sort of fit, like how it's draped on her. It's looking really nice. And then I'm loving how it has been styled with all the metal jewelry. That really nice long neck piece with the choker kind of broad neck piece is also there. And metallic rings and those earrings. Oh my God. It is just so beautiful. And I also like the fact that she kept her hair really tight in a sleek bun. Those golden eyes are just complementing the green sari, like, you know, it's just match made in heaven type. I'm loving that golden and green.
I like how she's kept her blouse really young. That noodle strap kind of gives us, adds a little lightness to that heaviness of the Banarasi sari. Also, the choice of color was really smart. It's pleasant and light to your eyes. Love it. Love the way she styled it. She hasn't overdone it. Just the neck pieces, earrings, and that one little bindi to complete the entire Indian look was all you needed. So definitely a brilliant, brilliant job. Love the styling, love the look, and we're completely crushing it. Okay, so third on the list is Madhuri Dixit Nene. She's wearing another very summery number. It's a yellow printed sari from Varun Behel. If you see, the sari has a very interesting border. It's chicken curry ka border. You generally don't see that. For me, honestly, I'm not gonna zoom into the details, because if I see it, she wore it for a reality dance show, and it's a very simple piece. She looks very nice in it. I like how she tried to enhance, or how do I say, to make this simple look rich. She added the whole ruby neck piece, which must be like shit expensive. For me, that's a little weird for the contrast, because itni flowy sari ke saath, I don't understand the gems. To be very honest, like thank God it has colors, so it kind of works. But overall, she's looking very pretty and she's carrying it very nicely. I like the way she's kept her natural tussle hair and fresh makeup, brown lips, and that little touch of bindi. That's about it. I'm not gonna say that I'm wowed out of my mind.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's a pretty look.
Yeah, it's a simple daytime promotional look or whatever event she was going for. And I like the yellow print. Actually, it's very, like she said, very summerish and easy breezy. Like, and yeah, it's the Georgia sari, I'm guessing, with the chicken curry border. So like the chicken curry border is bothering me a little because it's just like a unnecessary addition to it. Had it been like just a simple plain border or no border also, that would have also worked with me. And I actually like that pop of red with the ruby necklace and the rings and the bracelet that she went for. And it's diamond and ruby, so problem to kisi ko nahi hai. So really like that, and you know, makeup is fresh and hair is also natural, tousled hair. It's balanced nicely. Yeah, and she's looking really nice, and I think we both are
crushing it.
Okay, so next in the list is Mrinal Thakur, and she's wearing this gorgeous black raw silk lehenga by Raw Mango. So what I like about it, the outfit, I would say that it's simple, with the right amount of embroidery and elements that are supposed to shine. And I like the fact that they paired the lehenga with a choker, and it's of almost of the same color as the embroidery. So absolutely, I love the color combination happening with the clothes and the choker. So that's a very smart thing. And she went earrings less. She styled her hair in a side parted
clean bun
and cold eyes, nude lips. So it's a very well styled look because ऐसे extra hard try नहीं करा है.
I also have a lehenga which is very very similar, not as beautiful as this. Imagine black in raw silk and then it's a plain set inside, so it automatically is very rich and lush. Then she's wearing that dupatta which has this beautiful thread work happening all over it in like patches. That is adding as an accessory. So she's wearing that dupatta like a jacket. So I like how they've just made that statement stand out without disturbing the set inside. So that definitely is standing out for me. Second, as Vani said, going jewelry-less, but just that choker, which is pretty much the same color of the border that they have used on the dupatta. It's a great idea and a combination because they've very smartly divided the bling everywhere, that little bit. So this is a right example of that. Coming to her makeup, she looks stunning. I like how she's kept her hair very neat and into a side-parted bun. So that hair is definitely very, very formal. Cold eyes, brown lips. I think there's nothing that I don't like about this look. So we are crushing it. So now we have Meera Rajput. Meera Rajput slash Kapoor. I don't know if she's using which
help
name
yourself.
She, yeah. So Meera wore this pastel pink tulle lehenga set by Priyanka Gupta. It was from her summer collection. So definitely the color is beautiful. This set has a very voluminous tulle skirt which is high-waisted, which is absolutely plain with a lot of pleats. And it has been paired with the heavily embellished same color blouse. It has pearl embellishment and embroidery. I'm not saying it's my favorite, but it definitely is working here. It's looking very pretty. I like how she's draped the dupatta because anyway, the dupatta also has embroidery, and if you see, it has a scallop border. So it's not a very neat end. And I don't think we needed more drama as we already have a blouse full of it. Then again, that she chose to wear that choker, which almost looks like a collar. It's creating a nice
illusion.
So that is definitely working. And of course, she went jewelry-less other than that choker, kept her hair very nice in soft waves, blush, very fresh makeup with pink lips. Yeah, so overall, it's a nice look and she is looking very pretty. But technicality-wise, it's not my personal favorite.
Loving the color. And it's actually looking really nice on Meera. And the fact that the skirt is plain and the blouse is heavily embroidered. The embroidery is too much. And the dupatta is also embroidered at the ends with the scallop hem. And you know, wahan pe bhi pearls laga diye, wahan pe bhi nahi chhoda hai. But makeover's blouse mein, what is bothering me is that already you have put so much pearl. And then you have that embroidery also, you know. A lot of it. And it's like at some point it's intersecting with the pearl work also. The choker is working here. It's a polki choker that she's wearing, which is a beautiful piece, and somehow it is working with the lehenga. I like how she kept her hair and makeup really natural. That's what she always goes for. She's not one of those people who are like caked up or like, you know, sort of goes all out. That's what I like about her, that she keeps it very simple, and that's what suits her. She's looking beautiful, and the way it is in style, it's nice. So yeah.
So
we're gonna like crush it. Okay, so last on the list is Sonakshi Sinha, jo ekdam mast hawa ka jhoga lag rahi hai mujhe is waqt, loving what she's wearing. So she's wearing this white sharara set by Anita Dongre. First of all, I love how the sharara, like the pants, are of like different fabric. So the inside is a different fabric and then you have like net layered on top of it. So I like how it's looking like a skirt, and it's looking very Lucknowi for some reason. I like how delicate it looks, you know. It's white on white, first of all. Like, it has been embroidered and you see those little sequin work or some embellishment also happening somewhere in the middle. So that's really interesting. And I love how she paired the white with silver jewelry from Amrapali. Love those earrings and that one ring. Thank God Sonakshi went for like less accessories this time. Shankh shunkh nahi lagaye hain. It's really nice. She's looking really cute. Like, very super elegant. Super nice.
It's a beautiful, simple white on white piece. I like how the dupatta is sheer. And all the three whites are very distinct. Because they played with fabric, which was again a very smart thing. I like that the embroidery is limited to just the kurta, which is also very muted because it's silver. Mm. Very fine embroidery and it's in silver. So it's slightly muted, it's not very loud. So it's very day appropriate. And to match that embroidery, she's gone for silver jewelry and she's not overdone it. That one statement ring, jhumkis from Amrapali and her tousled hair, the natural curls that she gets. I think it's a very simple yet a very beautiful look. The only thing that I would have preferred is when you wear sharara with so much volume, give yourself a little height. You need the shararas to go up thoda sa for it to fall beautifully. So juttis somehow will be white. That definitely is slightly off for me. So I think it's a very simple look, but she's looking very beautiful and no major complaints as such. So we both are crushing it.
That was it for this episode, guys. Let us know what you thought of it in the comment section below.
And while you do that, don't forget to check out the POPxo shop. We've got amazing merchandise like coffee mugs, fanny packs, scented candles, doormats, and a lot more. The link is in the description box, so click on it and shop now.
And for more styling tips and tricks and news on celebrity looks, keep watching POPxo Daily.